Karate friends, welcome to Classics in Color, your weekly dive into some of the ancient world's wackiest facts. I'm Mark Graves, and today I want to talk about my personal favorite love story in Latin in honor of Valentine's Day. And please feel free to check out Patreon if you would like to see another video on my favorite Latin love poems. Most love stories in Roman and Greek literature are real bummers. They're real sad. Lots of terrible things happen. People get raped, there's incest, people get their heads chopped off. It's generally unfortunate scenarios because the general opinion or take in the ancient world is that lovesickness is something you want to avoid. It's a sickness and it causes you and everyone around you tons of problems. And I have to say, I pretty much agree with this. I would rather have a cold than fall in love. But loving someone as opposed to being in love with someone is different and can be a really good thing. And there's a great story about two people loving each other in Ovid's Metamorphoses. So this is a long poem filled with all kinds of different myths and stories, and most of them are love gone wrong, right? What I just said about all the horrible things happening to people. But right smack in the middle, we get the story of Philemon and Bacchus, which is the ancient world's cutest old couple, and they are basically the equivalent of Carl and Ellie. So I love them very much. Let's check out that story. So the story begins with the gods being really pissed at humanity in general, and Jupiter and Mercury come down to Earth and they start visiting humans in disguise to check them out, and everybody's super rude and mean to them, so they're like, we hate these humans. But then they get to Philemon and Bacchus's house, and there is this cute little old couple, and let me read a little quote for you. But pious old Bacchus and Philemon of equal age were in that cottage wedded in their youth, and in that cottage had grown old together. There they made their poverty light by owning it, and by bearing it in a contented spirit. So they've been married for forever since they were just kids, and they live in this little hut, and they're super poor, but they don't care because they just have each other and they're happy, and it's really sweet. So the gods show up and Philemon and Bacchus invite them in right away. They're very nice and hospitable. They serve them food, even though they don't have very much, but they give it to them. And then they also have this goose, which is their guard goose. Instead of a guard dog, it's supposed to, you know, hiss at and chase anybody who gets too close. So they want to butcher the goose and serve it to their guests because they really want to be good hosts, but they can't catch the goose because they're so old, so they're like hobbling after it, but it keeps running away from them. And the gods eventually say, you know, it's fine, don't worry about it. We pardon the goose can live. And so then the gods reveal themselves to Philemon and Bacchus and say, hey, we're gods, good job, you passed the test. And now you can leave your house and go climb up on that hill over there. So they do, no questions asked. They climb to the top of the hill, and when they look back, they see that the whole valley has been flooded and all their neighbors are gone. And they actually have a moment where they cry for a second, and it describes them crying and being sad, which I guess their neighbors were evil people because the gods didn't like them. But even still, Philemon and Bacchus are sorry for them that they got killed in a massive flood. And they also look back on their little hut, and it has been magically turned into a temple to the gods. So then Jupiter shows up again, and he says, you know, again, good job, you guys passed the test, and you're the only mortals around here for now. I'd like to give you a wish, right? He gives them basically a wish. And Philemon and Bacchus, they sort of consult for a second, they talk it out with each other, so they're smart that way. And they're one of the only people in the ancient world who get a wish and don't totally screw it up, right? And end up with things worse than they started with. So he goes to Jupiter with what they've decided, and he sort of asks for two things, but Jupiter doesn't complain, so I'm not going to either. And he says, well, first, we would like to serve in this temple that has appeared and be your priests, basically, for the gods and continue to thank you for not killing us. And then we would like to die at the same time, which is really sweet and humble, again, little request that they make. So Ovid, the author of this poem, even has Philemon say, we pray that the same hour may bring death to both of us, that I may never see my wife's tomb nor be buried by her. So just super sweet. And Jupiter says, of course, granted. And then let me finish the story in Ovid's words. They had the care of the temple as long as they lived, and at last, when spent with extreme old age, they chanced to stand before the sacred edifice talking of old times. Bacchus saw Philemon putting forth leaves, and Philemon saw Bacchus. And as the treetop formed over their two faces, while still they could, they cried with the same words, "Farewell, dear mate," just as the bark closed over and hid their lips. Even to this day, the Bithynian peasants in that region points out two trees standing together and growing from one double trunk. So again, it's just one of my favorite love stories, and really just stories in general from the ancient world, because it's so wholesome and happy and sweet, and that's kind of rare. So I hope you enjoyed it too, and have a lovely Valentine's Day. Thank you so much to subscribers and to Patreon members. I hope to see all of you again next week. Kairi Tai.